Nice going. Thank you very much. The first guest is a talented actor starring in a new film entitled Howl. It opens tomorrow in selected cities. I just pray to God your city has been selected. Please welcome the great James Franco, ladies and gentlemen. I have this picture right here on the desk, and I've heard a little bit about this. Tell us what we're looking at. Is that, in fact, you, James, there?
That is me, yes.
Where was that picture taken?
It's at Columbia University.
Columbia University. Now tell me, you're pursuing a graduate degree there, is that right?
It's a great way to kick it off. Yeah, I was. Yes, I was.
What was the degree?
It was a master's degree in creative writing.
Wow.
You can see I was working very hard. Oh.
And somebody just took the picture and there you go. Is that what happened?
I'm just lazy.
But you're doing other graduate work, is that correct? Not just at
Columbia. I'm sleeping through other programs. Yeah.
And how do you like that? People, what do they think having a famous film actor in their class and stuff?
I really don't know what they think. I know what one person thought. Mm. I got a weird email from a classmate once. And she said that she didn't know why I was at the school. I had a career. What was I doing going back to school? And that she was particularly upset with me that night because she was in the bathroom reading a magazine and she had to see my face. So not only did she have to see me in class, but she had to see me while she was going to the bathroom. And she was very upset about that.
She shouldn't be upset about that because there's nothing wrong with wanting to continue education.
No, I agree.
You can't do that.
No, I agree.
But what about the faculty? Do you get along well with the faculty members?
Yes, I get along with most of the faculty members.
Most of them.
I was at NYU as well for filmmaking. Mm-hmm. We talked about my first film there last time I was here. It was Naked Basketball Players.
Oh, right. I do remember that. Yeah. And your brother
I think
was
you left
in...
me. No, my brother wasn't in that one. But you said, well, good luck with that one, James.
Yeah.
Let's see how it goes. Well, it actually did pretty well. I took it to the Berlin Film Festival and I won an award. So there you go, Dave. Naked basketball is really big in Germany.
The Germans love their naked basketball, don't they? But the faculty, do people regard you as a film star, a movie star, or just a kid in school?
Well, no, at NYU, it was great. I mean, they taught me a ton there. I had the, film school kids dream. All my, films got into festivals. I sold them all. I made a documentary about Saturday Night Live. We sold it to Oscilloscope. Everything's perfect. But there was one teacher who, I don't know why, just didn't like my stuff.
Really?
And I did this film based on a poem called The Clerk's Tale. And it's basically a day in the life of this guy who works in Brooks Brothers. Mm-hmm. And it's not a lot of action. Part of the point of it is that it's very dull working. It can be dull, but it's also about the struggle to and the strength it takes to kind of have that job. So
not exactly a Chilean gold mine, though, is it? Talking about Brooks Brothers. He went a little off here, a little off there, and we put the cups in there.
That's basically the movie right there. That's it. But I wanted to spice it up. I had just seen this movie at this place called the Film Co-op, which is around here.
Uh-huh.
They have all these old great art films.
Right.
And there was this film that has two titles. One is called, one title is September 30th. The other title is, I can't really say the title, but it's... eating and drinking, and basically that's what the film is about. Mm-hmm. Bodily mm-hmm. intake right. and bodily,
digestion.
And it's by this guy Kurt Kren. Mm-hmm. And I have to say it was incredibly inspiring, and I thought, wow. I don't have any of this in, there's none of this in the poem that the movie's based on, but I gotta put this in the movie because, you know, you go out throughout the day and you do these basic things. Yeah. So I gotta put that in the movie.
Okay.
Well, this teacher, I don't know why, she wasn't so high on that, that idea. So she, you know, we had to do evaluations. She was very hard on me at the evaluation. But then the film got into Cannes
really?
Film Festival.
Wow.
Yeah, it was one of the best film festivals in the world.
Mm-hmm.
So we had a second year marathon at the end of the year where everybody in the second year shows their film to the public and family and friends, and, you know, people fly out. And I had taken out the risque scenes. And I asked them, I had a conflict. I said, can you screen my film at this time? Because I have a conflict. I have another film playing at the Tribeca Film Festival. I want to go to the marathon and go to the Tribeca Film Festival. Well, they didn't. Mm. They there was a conflict. So I was a little upset about that, and I was feeling a little naughty. So I put in a film that had these scenes in it. Mm. And I wasn't there, but I heard the reaction was large. And... And the poor guy, I was second to last, and there was a one poor guy, he's a great filmmaker, my friend Toshi. His parents had flown out from Japan, and he had, a light comedy that was the last thing, and I guess it did not play after the explicit bathroom scenes in my movie at all. And so that night when I went to the NYU party, my favorite teacher, walked up to me, and I could tell she had had a few drinks that night, and said, hi, hey, how's it going? And she shook my hand, and she said, this is my teacher. What an hole. To my amaze, my teacher. Twice she said it.
Yeah.
And
does that mean you get an A?
An A something, yeah.
Oh, my.
Yeah.
Now, I watched this movie, Howl.
Yeah.
I know very little about Allen Ginsberg.
Oh, really?
I think he was, before he might have had an impact on my life, I was not as old as, you know, anyway. And so yeah. I watched this thing. And it's incredible to me that this obscenity trial was going on in the 50s in San Francisco over poem that he had written.
Yeah.
I thought that was interesting. The other thing that's interesting is this film was a tremendous amount of work for you. I mean, it's nothing but you either being interviewed on camera or reciting the work of Allen Ginsberg.
Yeah.
And I just thought, how can you do that?
It was a very unusual, I mean, not just
but
playing
Allen
Ginsberg.
But it is a lot of
Ginsberg.
Work. Yeah, it is
I mean,
a lot.
There's the work of, you know, taking on a historical character and getting those mannerisms down and doing all of that kind of work. But then the structure of the film required, a very unusual kind of approach to the acting because essentially, for a lot of the film, I'm giving interviews as Allen Ginsberg.
Right.
So it's almost as if I'm doing what I'm doing right now.
Mm.
But it's scripted, mm-hmm. so I have to look like...
Yeah.
I'm coming up with the answer. You know what I mean?
Yeah, I know.
But it's almost, the script.
Yeah, I would think
like monologue.
It's quite a lot of work for you.
Yeah.
And this the poem that's featured, the name of the film, Howl, doesn't trip readily off the tongue.
It's complex.
Yeah. I was very impressed.
But there's
by
a rhythm.
That.
Oh, thank you. Thank you.
What is the clip we're going to see here?
I think I'm reading the poem in the clip.
Well, pretty good guess.
I didn't cut the clip out of the movie.
The movie is mostly of the poem.
My guess is I'm in Howl.
Here it is. Take a look. James Franco and Howl.
I'm with you in Rockland, where we wake up electrified out of the coma by our own souls, airplanes roaring over the roofs. They've come to drop angelic bombs. The hospital illuminates itself. Imaginary walls collapse. Oh, skinny legions run outside. Oh, starry spangled shock of mercy. The eternal war is here. Oh, victory. Forget your underwear. We're free.
Yes. See? It's Howl. Nice job, James, in that film. opens tomorrow in selected cities. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Don't neglect your studies.
I won't.
Thank you very much. We'll be right back with Sofia Vergara.